Hey folks, PC7 here, welcome back to the channel, and welcome back to Farm Sim 22. It is a beautiful Sunday morning here on the Sunshine Coast of British Columbia, and I think what we're going to do here, since our harvester and tractor are quite a ways off, or harvester and trailer with tractor are quite a ways off, we're just going to hook the New Holland up to the baler and continue baling that away. And we'll keep our eyes on the vehicle HUD there to figure out when the harvester needs us. Other than that, hope you're all having a great day. Let's turn you on. Let's lower you down. Let's gather. So yeah, continuing the busy harvest. Oh, good. Bale dropped right in the way of the row. That's okay. That's okay. Come on. Come on. There you go. Make me wait till the last second. Grab this. Yeah, I don't think we'll find we've got much of a straw bale shortage once this is done. Ooh. Do still have the oat field to collect from as well. How's that guy doing? Class Lexian canola, 79%. Oh, there we go, 80%. The big announcement, a worker has a tank. Oh, my workers are tanked. Explain a lot of their actions anyways. Just recorded an episode of The Infected. I don't know. I think I'm gonna pack that in. There's just so many frustrating things with that game. It's like everything that you can do, they've gone, whoa, wait a minute. It's not quite awkward enough. Hang on, let me do this. There we go. That should be terrible. And then they put that in. You know, they have made some nice steps forward, but there's still so many backward steps that need to be addressed that, yeah, it's just driving me nuts. Being suddenly attacked by four huge ghouls at once. I mean, right through your door, into your house, you know, and guaranteed you're going to get hit with some kind of a thing, whether it's you need to use bandages or medicated bandages. And to do that, you need something that is definitely not all that early game. Yeah. Anyway, I'm not going to get into the details, but yeah. I think there are a lot of good survival-style crafting games out there that don't seem to have the issues, so I think I'll just find something else. Okay, he's full now. And wrong way around as usual. Ah, well. At least it's nothing new. Ooh, looks like they just finished the field beside us, huh? Now that's... Is that another canola field over there? I think it is. Yeah. And again, with all these hedges and so few entries and exits, and all of them being tiny, we will have to re-trailer the just to go that distance. Yeah, so we will have to re-trailer the header and figure out how to get all that stuff over there. But we'll do that when we need to do that. There you are. I'll just get out of your way. Thank you for spraying seeds all over the top of my tractor. There you go. It's going to be a nice day here all day. I'm talking about on the farm, of course. It is supposed to be a nice day here in beautiful Powell River as well, although we are going to start getting a little bit of clouding over, which is all right. That's just going to bring the afternoon temperatures down a little bit, which I don't mind. So far, we haven't been hit with the bad air quality smoke from all the forest fires raging in Alberta and BC at the moment. It's quite the conflagration going on out there, especially I guess in central northern Alberta right now. I think there's well over 100 wildfires out of control. They've just evacuated a few more towns. And of course, this is only going to get worse every year. As temperatures continue to climb and weather patterns continue to change. It's not pleasant. A couple of years ago... Oh, okay, I think the harvester figures he's done. A couple of years ago, we... I guess there were some massive forest fires in China. And although it's a lot further away than Alberta or northern BC, we woke up one morning to a completely orange environment. It was like living inside Donald Trump. There was super thick smoke in the air. There was particles of soot over all the cars and vehicles and flat surfaces. A haze of smoke thicker than what we usually get for fog. So that was not fun. Like I said, so far this year we're doing all right. Of course, they're also saying that this is going to be the onset of a El Nino, and even more than that, what they're calling a super El Nino. So, won't get into the specifics, but it basically means that things are going to get warmer still. We might even have an incredibly warm winter. right, we are almost done. Well, at least, like I said, we've got the oat field to do. We'll move down there next. I think what I'm going to do is actually empty this guy. I know we're going to pick up the same thing, but... there we go. And good. All right, let's see if we can find our way over here. Yeah, that's kind of what I figured. You're not done so much as you quit. That's okay. That's okay. We'll take care of it. It's gonna be not quite, eh? That's alright. Okay. Whoop, stop now. There you go. Oh, that ain't my field. Whoops. Okay, then. Apparently it's over there. help! Oh, man. No, don't. Oh, for... that was purely because the brakes didn't work. Oh, man. That was purely because the brakes wouldn't stop the darn thing. Now it's gonna be stuck, isn't it? Oh, yeah. Oh man, we made it. Don't know if it's gonna do us much good. Come on. Oh, really? Seriously, dude, could you have made these fields any more awkward? You know? Wow. Alright, here we go. Well, I guess Sooty is all ready for his vacation. I guess he leaves tomorrow. Off to the mysterious Far East. Yes, indeed. Wow. Very, very cool. Very cool indeed. But the man works hard. He's a really good dude and deserves a good holiday. Can you say? Yeah, never again. No more UK maps. I'm not, I'm just not a big fan of doing things just to make them the most frustrating possible. And the hedges and the poor entryways and all of that, it may be realistic. And if it is, what the heck's the matter with you people? Why do you not try to make life easier for yourselves, you know? Yeah, good old species. He'll solve all the world's problems because, you know, he's, well, an idiot. Yeah, I know. I know, believe me. Okay. Now, I think what I'd like to do here, just because we are here. All right, so this is the field we just did, right? 94. Well, 7, as it's also known. Yeah. Okay, now that's this one. And there we go. All right, and let's just move you across. There we are. All right. Well, these are small fields, which is good, because I think from the general sheepitudinous of them that we're going to end up having to do them ourselves anyway. So, and yeah, we will be doing the same thing with these. As we finish them, we will dispose of them. I don't particularly need to be having fields way down here. We do have our cow farm next door, but I don't see a lot of point to it. Whoa. Yes, and once again, species succumbs to the laws of Darwinism. Oh, man. I don't know how long I've been at this here this morning. Whoops. I mean, I have a clock to the left of me. I have a clock to the right of me. I have a clock on my screen. No idea. No idea. Ah, boy. I tell you. Adjust. There we are. And done. Didn't get that much, but we are going to end up with a full trailer in canola, which is a pretty rare event, to be honest with you. Unless you have small trailers. I know, some guys have them. Ones that'll tell you size doesn't matter. But, yeah. When you're hauling grain, yeah, it does. There we go. That is a full trailer. That's what I was trying to do last time, was just bounce it over the fence posts. But unfortunately, because it wouldn't stop, yeah, I managed to hit it with the combine. Alright, so we're ready to go. We're ready to go with this guy as well. Like I said, we'll sell it now that we're have decanolicated it. Uh-huh. Ooh, that is one big trailer full of canola. Absolutely love it. And as you can see, right to our farm. Now, I don't believe there's a silo at this farm, so we do have to go all the way home with it, but oh well. We can do that. So let's go back to here, and you, bye-bye, there we go, and with that guys, I am going to call the episode. Hope everybody has enjoyed, and of course if you did, make sure you hit that like button. It does help out a bunch. Look forward to your comments, etc. Take care of each other. Have yourselves a great day. Ciao for now.